Okay, hello. So, as previously said, I'm really not a kernel hacker. I work in the LDAP and single sign-on field. Some of you were maybe present at RMLL security this summer in this room. And I gave a talk about single sign-on this summer. But today I will talk about you with you about free software, community, and good and bad habits. First, I'll present myself. My name is Clément Houdot. I work for Savoir Faire Linux. And some of people in Savoir Faire Linux are kernel hackers. So if you want to join us, we are hiring, okay? But this is not the topic for the moment. First question, are there any bastards in the room? Okay, maybe for now you don't think you are a bastard, but after this presentation you will be sure that you are a bastard, because we all have done one time in our life a bad thing with the community, with the free software, okay? So I think we are all bastards. I will explain why. The way I will explain this is a guide, so you can follow all what I will say to destroy the community, okay? It's a guide to be a perfect asshole with the free software, and I hope this will help some of us to destroy some good open source project. As you are working with the Linux kernel, I think you met a lot of bastards. But maybe you will learn something. So, we can be an asshole as a user, of course, because when we use the free software, we are often the bastard which use the free software. But we'll see also how to be a bastard as a developer. And to conclude, how to be a bastard as an enterprise, okay? Are some of you from an enterprise here who works in free software? Okay, so you are really big bastards. Okay, I know, because I work in a company that does free software. The first chapter is about mailing list. Okay, it's a big topic. So the first way to be a bastard is to not use mailing list, okay? Why? Because you can send mail directly to project leaders, okay? They have a private mail, they have a private life, but as a user, you can bother them and you can send mail directly to them. What you can do is paste text trace on IRC channels. So, yes, you can do that. And, of course, we have social media, so use Twitter and Facebook to ask for help or to report bugs is a good way to do, okay? And please use some smileys. It's really nice to have a bug and to say, ooh, I have a bug, okay, voila. You can open issues in bug trackers, but just to ask questions. Of course. No. Okay. If you really want to use the list, what you can do is never register. Okay? Because you have administrators that are here to moderate your message. Okay? And if they don't moderate, you can be rude and send them to send mail to them to say, oh, I send a mail on the mailing list and it does not appear. Okay? Whoever have someone that say, okay, that can't register on mailing list and sending mail, oh, it don't work. Check your spam, okay? So this is the first way. You can have a vacation away message. Okay. This is always nice. In summer, you have always a lot of message. Okay, I'm on vacation. Oh, way. Okay. You can also send your picture of you in vacation. And, okay. Do not answer to the list, but directly to the user, to the sender, okay? You want to get help, you don't want to give help. This is how to use them. And, of course, you can invite the list to your professional network. Okay, now you really want to write on the list. Okay, it's a nice step. So to do that, use your mother tongue. Okay, we all know Google Translate. So anybody we do computing, so we can use a translator service. Answer on top, of course. Don't include original text. Use HTML, picture, uppercase, etc., etc. You can do. And of course, fit the form. Okay. If you don't know nothing about the subject, please comment. So, next chapter is about bugs, because there are always bugs. So, how to find bugs? You can first use very old versions. Okay, I have a big bug here, but my version is 5 years. Okay. Use non-official patch, of course. Use RAD operating systems. Okay. But the most interesting is to let your children play with the software. Of course, it's never a reproducible bug with the children. And now you want to report a bug. Of course, don't search if bug was already open. Okay, we love to create duplicate bugs. It does not work. Okay. Of course. Why are you open the bug? Because it does not work. And you want a quick solution for free, but of course you can't take the patch. You don't have time. Okay. The word I like when you're asking for a solution is ASAP, as soon as possible, because this is my business. I need it.
I have one more for this.
Yes, why?
You can open the button and go away.
Yes, of course. Okay. And you see that a lot of users are saying, oh, me too, okay. That's good. So, maybe more interesting as a developer, because as a developer, we have the power inside the software, okay? So we can do a lot of evil things. First chapter is documentation. I think you already have talked here about documentation, but as a bastard, first, we know we have some acronyms that we like to have. So the first is, okay, where is the manual? And to-do is to all documents. And of course, with the source is the best documentation for a developer. Another problem with documentation, sometimes there are no documentation, but sometimes there are documentation everywhere. So you can create files in project, so README install. So you create it, but you never update them. Okay. You can install an open wiki. And when I say open, it's without authentication, of course. And you like to answer mail on mailing list. Okay, so you will write a two-page answer, but this answer will never appear in any documentation. So you can resend the mail or send a link on the mail archive and say, ah, I already answered to that. Okay, it's nice. Okay, and to conclude, of course, the quality. If you're a bastard developer, quality is not for you, of course, because test is done. Never test. Users are here for the test. Okay. To conclude, we have the enterprise. So an enterprise is a big actor in a free software because it has the money. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting because with the money, you can do a lot of things. First, you can be just an enterprise that will use the free software. Okay. What you can do is first talk about license. Okay, well, what the fuck? We don't need license. We will add this to Bob. Okay, it's not big problems. And you can say, oh my God, it's free. It's free, okay. You can take it. Give something back, okay. Of course, it's a nice idea, but you don't have time to do that. And community, what is community? Okay, we are not you are not doing politics here. So, as a enterprise, don't imply yourself in free software. But we have some companies that are doing free software, making free software, and here you can, of course, fork instead of contributing. So this is the fork as a service. Always fork, okay, never contribute. Of course, keep interesting feature for enterprise edition because only big companies use them. And create a new license. Yes, you can hire a team of lawyers because you know there are a lot of licenses, but no one fits on it. So create a new license. And don't let external people contribute because they always will not be as good as you. So keep your free software only for you. So that's how to be a bastard as an enterprise. I think that's all is the complete guide. But as you see, you have a lot of ideas. We can complete this guide. If you like this. Guys, you can connect to my Twitter account, Creative Corner. It's mostly in French, okay? It's for French-speaking people. And if you like the grumpy gnome on the picture, you can have a look to Dungeon Legacy. It's a web series. I was an actor in this web series, so you can have a look to it. And of course, if you have questions, I won't answer to them. No, I'm kidding. You can ask the question if you want.
I have one more for reporting a bug.
Yes.
Reporting to a project which is not related to your issue.
Ah, yes, you can do that.
Because you are trying to explain to the guys this is not related to you, but to someone else, but he's still convinced this is because of you and you don't want to handle the bug, and so you're getting a crazy loop, and this one is nice.
Yes, but as all software are running on a kernel Linux, we can report to kernel Linux.
Yes.
And opening a report by simply responding to an unrelated message on the mailing list.
Yes, yes, yes. There are a lot of things to do. I know you are all bastards and you know how to do that. Okay. That was great. Yes. Yes, communicate a lot. Yes, you are the spammer. Yes, yes, of course.
As a company, you can also take a product that's 2 years old and that used to be certified as secure, package them in your secure product, and give the credit to the original company that did release the product like 2 or 3 years earlier.
Of course, because it is a stable version.
Stable version for the win.
Okay. Thank you.